MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the American League Division Series between the Houston Astros and the Minnesota Twins. Everyone, Matt Vasgersian, welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
And you got to figure here in a five-game series, the odds are long for coming back when you're down 2-0. But hey, it's not impossible. It's been done before, but you can bet the other guys are hungry to end this thing right here and now to give themselves a couple of days off before the next series. This should be a good one.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Jose Berríos is on the mound, and he'll look to wrap up this division series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, not a very good start in his last one, Matt. Only 4 innings, so he did get a no decision. But he's a much better pitcher than that, and I know that they're expecting more than 4 innings, hopefully a win, too, out of this guy in this one.
Ready now is Jose Altuve, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Center field, and he's on to start the ball game. It's a base hit. The throw into second, and he's out trying to stretch it into a double, so a costly mistake here leading off the inning. At the plate now, Alex Bregman. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Game time temperature tonight, 62 degrees, but should drop into the 50s before we're done. One out, nobody on. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
3-1, and he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of a steal when he's on base.
And that's the beauty of having a guy in the two hole like him. He's almost like another leadoff hitter, working a walk with just one out, and I think there's a good chance that he's going to be on the move at some point.
One out, runner at first, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Bregman, the runner at first, with one gun in the inning. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Garlic is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Here's Carlos Correa now. Lifetime against Jose Berríos. A number of meetings. He's 1-for-7. Over to first, and a dive, but he's back in. The 1-1 home.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base, almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
The 2-1 home. Right side, hit hard, and that finds its way through for a base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Hey, guys, I like the execution by the batter there. He got a hanger in the middle of the plate. He could have come unglued, but he didn't. He stayed focused and drove a line drive base hit.
Into the box now, Yordan Alvarez. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. Hit hard back up the middle. He's got it. On the first, and the Astros can't cash in as that ends the inning. Two left for the Astros. The Twins coming up. No score. Framber Valdez will do his best on the mound to keep his team alive here in the division series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Max Kepler, the next to grab a bat. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1.
Two balls, two strikes.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, Jorge Polanco. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Counts even, 2-2 for Polanco. Popped up, Bregman over to his left. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Batting third. The third baseman, Donaldson.
The next twin up, Josh Donaldson, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hoo-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Twins are set down 1-2-3. We are still scoreless. Second inning set to go. And next it'll be the fleet-footed first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Well. Count is 2-1.
Lays off the slurve there, and it's 3-1 now.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
The 3-1 pitch. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner, and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Next up for the Astros, Kyle Tucker. That's ball three now as it just misses below the zone. 3-2 pitch. Lifted the other way down the left field line.
Garland
will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Batting it, the center fielder, number 3.
Striding in for Houston, Miles Straw. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Throw over to the bag, and he'll dive back in. Heading out towards shallow right. Kepler's there for it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And with two away now, let's have a look at our playoff tree. And as you can see, the winner of this series faces a stern test ahead with the evil empire, the New York Yankees, waiting for the winner in the ALCS. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Fouled away. Gurriel is off of first with two away. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Jose Altuve. He was cut down at second, attempting to stretch a base hit his first time through.
Yeah, Matty, his wheels got him in trouble a little bit last time. Tried to take advantage, thought the defense was napping a little bit. In retrospect, maybe he should have just shut it down.
We'll have to leave it there as the play is made for the third out. A couple of walks, but no damage. We'll have more of game three after this message. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and standing in is the DH, Nelson Cruz. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Two and two.
Hey, that's just a nice get me over curveball there to steal a strike. I don't think he was looking for that one.
Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he got him.
That is good.
Stepping up is Miguel Sano. Bottom of the second here with no score. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. One and two.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And another foul ball. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
Wow, his stuff looks electric coming out the gates in this one, guys. That's five batters faced, four strikeouts. That's going to be a tough pace to keep up, but it looks like he has what it takes to work deep into this game.
In now, Kyle Garlick. 2-1 pitches, a sinker swung out and missed. 2-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
3-2 now. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit on the ground out to short. Right to him. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Down go the Twins in order. We'll move to the third with no score. Top of the third set to get underway, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman. Here's the 1-1 pitch.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Fastball well outside.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Well, in a scoreless game, you want to do anything you can to jumpstart your offense. With the speed of this guy on first, don't be surprised if he gets the green light here.
Now at the plate, here is Michael Brantley. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. But the runner's back easily. There goes Bregman off of first. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Buxton is going to get back, and he'll put this one away on the warning track for the first out. Well, that was certainly a tough play, and worth taking another look with Showtrack. Seemed to get a pretty good read off the bat, carved out a nice route, and ended up covering over 110 feet to make the play. I'm sure he's happy with himself about that one. At the plate, Carlos Correa. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. Shot toward right center. And a dive, but it rattles in and out of the glove. And the throw in gets away from him. The throw's in quickly as the go-ahead run holds at third. Second and third now.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Into the box, Yordan Alvarez. And it looks like one that misses ball four, so that'll load him up, but at least the double play is in order here with one away.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone, so you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
So here's Yuli Gurriel. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Gurriel behind the ball and two strikes.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
Here comes the 1-2. Chopped to third. Tough to get two. Donaldson's up with it. The second for one. On to first. Not in time as the umpire was right there to make the call.
Well, they really didn't have a shot at turning two on the high chopper. They only get one, and that allows the runner from third to score.
So the next to bat will be Kyle Tucker. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Ready with the 1-1. Ooh, jumped the gun a bit on that swing. He's down 1-2. Runners on first and third, two away. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. From the stretch, the 1-2. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. Houston leads this one 1-0. Matt Vaskersian, Mark DeRosa, and Dan Plesac back with you as Byron Buxton readies to lead off the inning. Swing and a miss. That's strike three.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
Standing in now, Ryan Jeffers. And he fouls this one off.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back off speed, then he's laid on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
He's looked great on the bump the first few innings of this game, and I think his ability to change speeds effectively has been a big reason why. That was a good change of speed for the strikeout there, and I've seen a lot of hitters look pretty off with their timing so far.
Into the box now, Andrelton Simmons. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Looked like the sinker there, dipped a little below the knees. A bouncer up the middle. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first, saves an error as the side is retired. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They still trail 1-0. Welcome back to Truist Park outside Atlanta as we send it down to check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've earned 5 walks in the game, and he said that's not only leading to a lot of run-scoring opportunities, but it's also forcing the pitching on the other side to work a lot harder and throw more pitches than they want to.
All right, Heidi, thank you. New inning set to get underway, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another 2-2 offering.
We got 3-2.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Digging in next, Jason Castro worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Fouled off. Strong on at first, nobody out. Got him. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as it can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
So now to the plate, Jose Altuve. 1-2 now. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Buxton is back, and he'll get there to make the play for out number two. And now, Alex Bregman. Alex Bregman. 1-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way.
We got a full count.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Hit hard on the ground to third, right to Donaldson. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Astros lead one. They lead it 1-0. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder Max Kepler.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Tucker is underneath this one. One down.
Now back.
Striding in is Jorge Polanco, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
It's hard to come up with any rhyme or reason why switch hitters hit from one side better than the other, but if you look at the numbers, he's successful hitting right-handed against left-handed pitching.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. On the ground to the left side. And there's out number two. So two gone now for the Twins in their half of the fourth. And here's Donaldson. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Now a swinging bunt. Two pitch. Grounded back up the middle. Onto the first baseman Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Can't start any better than this. He set down the first 12. Onto the top of inning number five we go. Astros lead this one 1-0. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder Michael Brantley. The 1-1 delivery. A shot to second base and handled for the first out.
Up next to the Astros, the shortstop.
So one down, no one aboard. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fly ball out toward left center field. Buxton is there, two gone. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. It was a walk in his last trip.
We got
3-2 now.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count. Do you sit changeup, or do you stay with the heater?
The next 3-2. Swing and a miss for the third strike as he went after what would have been ball four. Instead, the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3, but they lead it 1-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Here now the 2-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Really good pitch right there. So you're moving the ball all around the strike zone. Now what do you do? You come in. That's a hard pitch for any hitter to do anything with. Just really makes it difficult to get that bat head out.
At the plate now, Miguel Sano. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. First hit in this one for Minnesota.
I mean, that's a well-executed curveball right there. Pitcher does exactly what he wants to do. Gets the hitter out on his front foot, gets him out and around the baseball, and still finds a hole.
To the plate now, Kyle Garland. Breaking ball that time, but misses out of the zone.
Well, these guys haven't had too many opportunities yet to test the running game in this one, so they could decide to put a man in motion right here.
Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitch his second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Hit back up the middle. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. One pitch, two outs. A pitcher's best friend in the inning. Back with more from Game 3 after this. Ladies, Matt Shoemaker takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Twins, number 32, Matt Shoemaker.
Now it'll be Yuli Gurriel. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. And the pitch on 2-1. Chopper to short. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Stepping in once again is Kyle Tucker. He flew out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim most recently. Swing and a hard hit grounder, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Here comes the 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Strong. This is on the ground over the first, and this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Nothing fires me up more than watching an offensive player stay inside a baseball and drive it the other way.
Runner back standing. Strong, the runner at first with two gone. Stepping in now, Jason Castro. He's waiting on the breaking ball there and sends it to deep right field. And, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. The runner from first crosses the plate. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance, and he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
In now, Jose Altuve. Smoke toward third. Donaldson's there. Throw on to first, gets him, and the shot is retired. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. Through five and a half, it's now 2-0 Houston. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Byron Buxton. Now the 2-1. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. So only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Well, that's only the second hit he's given up tonight, and the first one didn't do any damage. So he's not sweating this one at all. They haven't been able to string anything together.
Into the box now, Ryan Jeffers. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Here's a look over to first, and he's back standing. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Grounder down the line at third. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? And what's even more impressive, no walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
At the plate, Andrelton Simmons. Oh, and this is hit high and deep out to left. And that'll get down out there near the wall. Buxton rounds the corner and is headed home. Safe at the plate as it's now a one-run ball game.
When this thing left his bat, I started thinking it might have enough to get out of here. Didn't quite carry enough, but it does one hop the wall off the track, and he cruises into second with an RBI two-bagger. You'll take that every day of the week.
So now to the plate, Max Kepler. And a little tapper here in front of the mound as this may work as a sacrifice. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. So stepping in is Jorge Polanco, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. One and one. Here it is. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Hit out toward second. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. A run for the Twins, and it comes on this RBI double. The 2-3-4 hitters now to start the seventh. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. Seventh inning ready to roll. And that'll give way to the third baseman, Alex Bregman. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
You never want to take the aggression away from a ball player, but in this situation, I'd like to see the leadoff guy try and work the count a little bit more, especially when this pitcher's missing like he is.
And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. So the Astros put a man aboard to get the inning underway. Standing in now, Michael Brantley. Fastball called strike, 1-2.
Hey, you know in the back of your mind as a batter right here, he's got that nasty sinker.
I know it's 0-2, but he might not be looking for the punch out. You have to find a way as a batter to get that two-seamer up in the zone, or you're going to ground into a double play.
To two balls and two strikes now. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be two? To second for one. On to first, and they get the double play. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
A swing and a miss at a sinker. The strikeout retires the side. Inning is over. Astros are down quietly. They lead it 2-1. For the seventh here, and digging in is the big time power threat, Josh Donaldson. One. Swing and a ground ball to third. Bregman fields it cleanly on to first, and that is a big out to lead off the home seventh. Up next for Minnesota, Nelson Cruz struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
One out, nobody on. A bouncer up the middle. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. A hit in two tries so far. A bouncer to the left side. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. So they go down without a whimper here. Eighth inning coming up. The Astros on top, 2-1. Begin the eighth, and next will be the imposing power bat, Yordan Alvarez. All even now, 2-2. Again, another foul ball. Ready with another 2-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Now the 3-2 pitch. A shot to second base and handled for the first down.
The first base is number 10, Gurriel.
Next up, Yuli Gurriel. He's got an RBI despite an 0-for-2 effort to this point. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Hit in the air down the right field line. And that's in there. Base hit. And this will bang up against the wall. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
When you're leading by one run, you want to do everything you can to add to the lead and give your bullpen a little breathing room. It makes a big difference, so double here goes a long way towards making that a real possibility.
Cody Stashek gets the call as he'll pitch with one gone in the top of the eighth.
Number 51, Cody Stashek.
Stepping in next, Kyle Tucker. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Now the 2-1.
Ball three.
You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Lifted down the line and left. Left fielder is on the move, and that'll get down for a base hit. Gurriel is on his way home, and he is safe at the plate, and they now lead by two.
Boy, that's a big RBI right there to give this team a two-run cushion going into the late innings. And it always makes it easier on the opposing pitcher to know they have a two-run lead.
Yeah, Leo Mazzoni always used to say, old pitching coach for the Atlanta Braves, solos won't kill us, guys. And he's absolutely right. You give yourself a two-run lead, a solo homer is not gonna do too much damage.
Plate now, Miles Straw. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. And the indication from the dugout comes, it looks like they're going to put him on intentionally, so that'll set up the double play possibility with one away.
That's what's called getting the treatment. Everyone knows he's a power threat with the bat, so it's all about not letting him be the guy that beats you.
Digging in will be Jason Castro, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. So 1-2.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Starting to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. So two gone now in the Houston eighth. And striding in, the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. So 1-1 home. Misses, ball two.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
The 2-1 misses down below the knee.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting at fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. On the ground toward the hole, and it's through. A base hit. Tucker rounds third and is digging for the plate. Safe at the plate as they extend their lead to 3.
Hey, Dero, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to 3. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that 3-run cushion has to make you feel good.
Stepping in now, Alex Bregman. 2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your A swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Straight 3 called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. So 2 runs on 3 hits, no errors, and 2 men left stranded. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. It's the Astros 4 and the Twins 1. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Kyle Garland. Here comes the 1-2. is taken for ball two. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game. So next to bat will be Byron Buxton, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Outside, that's the ball.
Ryan Jeffers is on deck. Three balls and two strikes to the Twins center fielder.
Even though we're late into this ball game, this guy's velo is still top notch. This guy's a horse.
The 3-2 pitch. One run on three hits and no errors in the ball game for Minnesota. He spoils another one and will do it again. Another full count pitch home. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
When you're this deep into a start, it can be really exhausting and annoying when a hitter now makes you work as hard as he did right there. He got the strikeout. That's great, but he's probably thinking, get that guy out of here.
So next to hit is Ryan Jeffers, and they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, and it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
The 1-1.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Line toward the alley in left center. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
Here's the fourth hit of the game, and it's a good one. Puts a good swing on this thing, and it goes for a double. We'll see if they can build on it here.
Into the box now, Andrelton Simmons reaches out for one and hits it on the ground to second. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. We'll have more of Game 3 after this message. Taylor Rogers enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Nope, hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Now here's the pitch. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Full count now, 3-2. Misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Now batting, shortstop, Carlos.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. Lifetime against this particular arm. Small sample, a perfect one for one. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. Popped up. Polanco shading to his right. One down. Striding forward now is the DH, Yordan Alvarez. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Three and one.
Well, that's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Two picks. Skied into straightaway right. Kepler is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run and get you a ribbon.
The count now at 2-1. From the belt, the pitch. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slide.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. One left for Houston as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Ryan Pressly enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 55, Ryan Pressly.
Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And the throw is there to record the first down.
Now back.
And there are the final numbers for the Astros starting pitcher. And he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance.
Hey, Matty V, this guy had it going in this one. You look down at the bottom of that scroll. 10 strikeouts. He hit that swing and miss stuff from the beginning all the way to the end in this one.
And now Jorge Polanco. And that catches the high outside corner. 1-2 now.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Hit on the ground toward the left. Bregman has it. Throw on the first will get him. Score at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Next, here is Josh Donaldson. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight.
Now, this is a perfect example of why this manager feels so confident going to this beast in the ninth right here. He is throwing absolute thunder right here. And looks the part.
Final strike for the Twins. Fouled away.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Man, a hitter must feel hopeless against that kind of guess. That final pitch was a 100-mile-an-hour fastball, and this thing is over.
Wow. one more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. A 4-1 finish in this evening's game. The Houston Astros trail 2-1 in this postseason series. Framber Valdez earns the victory on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight, first for the